this morning I want to talk to you about two things. First of all is publication in journals, and secondly, matters concerning academic ethics. But first, let me introduce myself. My name is Carson Lewis Jenkins. I'm a visiting professor at the School of Tourism and Services Management in Nankai University. Now, the two things I want to talk to you about are very much linked, but they're also essential for anyone undertaking a career as an academic. And the title of my presentation, of course, is Aiming for the Top. So why have I said aiming for the top? And the answer is in evidence provided by Professor Bob McKercher of Polytechnic University, Hong Kong. And over the last few years, Professor McKercher has examined the development of tourism and hospitality as publication sectors. And he now tells me that there are over 300 and more like 350 journals with the title Tourism on its cover. So this means there is enormous opportunity of publishing in various journals. But as students contemplating a career as an academic, your reputation will depend very much not only on what you publish, but where you publish. And therefore, in saying aiming for the top journals, what I'm suggesting to you is that whatever you are researching in your particular field, there are recognized journals, perhaps ranked 1, 2, or 3. You should always attempt to get your work at a standard which will allow you to submit a research piece to those journals. Now, if I say there are 350 journals you could possibly publish in, then you say, wait a moment, I'm starting my academic career. Which journals should I aim for? And this becomes a matter of experience. You do not have the experience. So where will you get advice? And I would say your starting point is with your supervisor. You say to your supervisor, I have been working, or we have been working on this particular topic. And it's almost at a stage where we think it might be sent to a journal. Which journal do we submit it to? And to a very large extent then, that decision will depend on two things. One, it'll depend on your supervisor's judgment on the quality of your work. That's the first thing. Is it ready to submit to any journal? And secondly, which journal best suits what you want to publish? And this can be a very debatable subject, because as I say, there are now probably 350 journals you could target. But essentially and eventually, when you are being evaluated as an academic, then one of the questions will be not only how much have you published, but where have you published? Have you managed to publish in the top journals? And if you have, this will look very good indeed on your CV. Now then, how do we publish? Well, first of all, on any piece of research, there has to be a title. And you say, well, this is easy. I know what I'm writing about, but it's not easy. Because remember, you know what you're writing about, but people who are going to review this publication for a journal want to be sure that what you write reflects your title. So the choice of title then becomes very, very interesting indeed. Let me take you an example. Let's assume you're writing some research on island tourism. So the title is Tourism in Islands, full stop. And you think that's an accurate title. In one way it is, in another it's not. Because if you look at the tourism literature, we subdivide the word islands. There are small islands, say in the Caribbean and in the Pacific. There are very large islands like Madagascar. And if you want to extend the term to its full capacity, then Australia is an island. So one of the things you might have to do is say, this article is about tourism in small islands. It might be in small Caribbean islands. It might be in Pacific islands. And now there's another subcategory, which is island, what we call cold water islands. So these are islands then, which are not normally on the tourist horizon. So that question of the title becomes very important. It should reflect what the content of your article is going to say. And try and get a title which captures the reader's intention. Now, the title must be accurate. If it's not accurate, then people say, well, I read this article, but it's misleading. Because the more I read in the article, the less relevant it is to the title. So the title has to be accurate. But if you can get a title which is captivating by the use of words, then very often you find that this becomes important. For example, someone might say a holiday destination which is world-class, or a holiday destination then suited for elderly people. So that adds a bit more power to your title. And in a sense of the choice of journal becomes very important, because sometimes you might publish something to do with tourism or services management or hospitality, but not in a mainline tourism journal. So for example, in my own area, which is basically political economy and tourism development, then very often I would choose one of the development journals for that publication, rather than say for tourism management or Annals of Tourism Research. And I would never publish in the Journal of Tourism Research, because that's a highly quantitative journal and it's not something which I publish in. So again, the choice of journal is important, but again, the reflection must be in the title, because the first thing the editor would look at when you submit your paper, is this relevant for our journal? Then what every journal will ask you to do is write an abstract. Could be 100 words, could be 200 words. Now, what is an abstract? It's a summary of your paper. It's a condensed version of your paper, and in it, you are trying to pass on certain information. What you need to do is highlight the scope of the paper. What is it this paper is about? Secondly, I think you have to say very briefly how you've done it. So you said this is based on a quantitative analysis or a qualitative analysis or a joint analysis. It involved fieldwork, including things like surveys. So very briefly tell people not only what you've done, but to a little extent how you've done it. And then the most important thing in that summary is to say to the reader what you found out as a result of this research. You know, is there anything new you found out? Or have you confirmed existing research? How relevant is it to the existing literature? And the most important thing is this: conform to the word length. If it says 500 words, if it says 100 words, do not exceed that. Because if you do, you'll antagonize the editor. Because sometimes we don't recognize and don't realize when we publish papers or submit papers, publishing is a very expensive thing. And therefore, if we exceed word length, editors are not going to be happy and they may send it back to you and say, please do this again. So the abstract then, if you like, is the summary of your paper. So if you go online, find a title which interests you, have a read of the abstract, and you say, well, yeah, this is something I'm interested in, I will read. Or you may say, no, this is not what I want to look at. Okay, so these, I think, are the very, very important first steps. The first step, then, is to find yourself a title. Secondly, is to ask your colleagues, ask your experienced publishers, where do you think this paper would be published? And then thirdly, make sure that your title reflects what you've done. And at that stage, what you should do, of course, is to go to the online journal or to the published journal and read very carefully what it says its interests are, and also things like style, because if you don't get that right at the beginning, then revision's going to be very, very tedious.